Welcome to this video. In this video, I show you step by step how to extend Wi-Fi signal without cables with OpenWRT router. I use an OpenWRT router that connects to the main router without a cable. It will help me expand the Wi-Fi coverage of my network. Devices connected to it wired and wireless can access the internet. First, use your computer to connect to one of the LAN ports of the OpenWRT router. The default IP address of the OpenWRT router is 192.168.1.1. Because the main router's IP address is 192.168.1.1, I will change the OpenWRT router's IP address to avoid conflicts. In this case, I changed the IP address to 192.168.2.1. After completing the IP address change, disable the DHCP server. You do this to avoid conflicts between the two DHCP servers on the main router and the extension router. Devices connected to the extension router are assigned IP addresses from the main router. Because the DHCP server has been disabled, to access this router, you set a static IP address for the computer connected to it. In this case, I set the IP address 192.168.2.10 for my computer. In this section, I set up client mode for the extension router. The extension router will scan for wireless networks around it and connect to the main router as a client device. You follow these steps. On N-band, I scan for surrounding wireless networks. After scanning, it shows that there are many wireless networks around. In this case, I connect to a wireless network called netvn. I assigned it to a zone named LAN. Make sure to set up a fixed channel in the same channel as the main router. In this case, I set up channel 1 on the main router, so I also set up channel 1 on the extension router. Save and apply changes. Because I use this router in bridge mode, I will delete the WAN interfaces. Next, I will delete the WAN zone in the firewall configuration. So this router becomes transparent in my network. The connection interface between the main router and the extension router is called W1. By default, this interface is assigned a dynamic IP address from the main router. But to relay between the W1 interface and the LAN interface, you set up a static IP address for this interface. In this case, I set the IP address 192.168.1.30. The gateway IP address is the IP address of the main router. Set the DNS address to the main router's IP address. I have completed setting up the static IP address for the W1 interface. I will check to see if this router has an internet connection or not. So the extension router has an internet connection even though it is not cabled to the main router. Our next task is to relay between the W1 interface and the LAN interface. To relay between interfaces, you search and install the package called Lucy Proto Relay. After completing the installation of this package, I recommend that you reboot the router to apply the changes. Now you create a new interface. This interface is responsible for relaying between interfaces. In this case, this new interface relays between the W1 interface and the LAN interface. The local IP address is set to the same as the IP address of the W1 interface. A new interface has been created, and as you can see, there is traffic on this interface. Because I use the N-band to connect to the main router, I will create a new Wi-Fi network on the AC band. Devices connected to this device will be connected to the internet. Wireless or wired, although this extension router connects wirelessly to the main router. This is very suitable for areas where you cannot install cables. In the previous step, I set up a static IP address for this computer, so to access the internet, I set up a dynamic IP address for it. This computer will be assigned an IP address from the main router, and from there it connects to the internet. As you can see, it is connected to the internet. Above are the steps to expand a wireless network without using cables with an OpenWRT router. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. This is my extension router. It doesn't have any cable connection on both LAN port and one port. However, when I use a smartphone connected to it, on my phone I can still connect to the internet. Good luck.